Hello everyone, Virginia Tach here and I welcome you back to another video in our VOKK TV series to rediscovering and preserving the Khmer Krom identity. It has been my pleasure and honor to volunteer for the Khmer Skampuchea Krom Federation, especially working with our KKF youth and VOKK teams. Thank you for all of your empowerment to energize me to continue to making this video series. As an organization advocating for the fundamental rights of the voiceless Khmer Krom in Kampuchea Krom, the KKF leaders have tried their best to bring the human rights violations against the Khmer Krom to many different meetings of the United Nations. One of the annual meetings that the KKF has attended since 2005 is the MRIP, Expert Mechanism on the Rights of Indigenous Peoples. KKF's representatives have attended the UNPFII, United Nations Permanent Forum on Indigenous Issues, since the third session in 2004 in New York City. This was the first time that the human rights violations against the Khmer Krom were brought up by the representatives of KKF at the United Nations headquarters. To be more effective in advocating for Khmer Krom's rights, in 2005, the KKF's representatives started attending the WGIP, Working Group on Indigenous Populations, at the UN office in Geneva. On March 15, 2006, the UN General Assembly replaced the UN Commission on Human Rights with the UN Human Rights Council. The roles of the WGIP had been reviewed for not doing the duplicated works as a UNPFII. In 2007, the UN Human Rights Council replaced the WGIP with the MRIP as a subsidiary of the Council. The expert mechanism is composed of 7 independent experts on the rights of Indigenous peoples. During their mandated term, the 7 members work in their individual capacities to provide the Council with expertise and advice on Indigenous peoples' rights as enshrined in the United Nations Declaration on the Rights of Indigenous Peoples. Each year, the session of MRIP is held for 5 working days at the UN office in Geneva. To prepare for more future activists, KKF has sentenced the Khmer Krom youth to attend the MRIP, just like participating in the UNPFII in New York. Due to the impact of the COVID-19 pandemic, the 13th session of the MRIP this year had been delayed from June 8th to the 12th to November 30th to December 4th. As of now, the outbreak of COVID-19 has continued to rise in numbers. Thus, the MRIP scheduled the 13th session into 4 virtual regional meetings. Each meeting would be held for 2 hours. In the past, this meeting streamed live on UN Web TV for people to follow along. The topic for the meeting this year was the impact of COVID-19 on the rights of Indigenous peoples under the UN Declaration on the Rights of Indigenous Peoples. Mr. Srewat Prak, KKF's Executive President, submitted a statement to the MRIP. The statement will soon be posted on the MRIP's website. I had a chance to read the statement, so I would like to briefly summarize it for you. First of all, I would like to thank Mr. Srewat Prak for bringing up the issues that have exposed and impacted the Khmer Krom's daily living in Kampuchea Krom during the COVID-19 crisis. Living under the regime denying the Khmer Krom's indigenous rights, Mr. Srewat Prak mentioned that the Khmer Krom did not receive any public or financial assistance from the Vietnamese government during the COVID-19 crisis. Most of the Khmer Krom peoples are farmers living in rural areas and are the Mekong Delta's poorest people. They have minimal access to the public health facilities to receive free COVID-19 tests. Thus, most of the Khmer Krom people have not been able to get tested for COVID-19. When the Khmer Krom would feel sick and experience symptoms related to COVID-19, they would use the Khmer Krom's traditional flu treatment using herbal medicine called spong. Fortunately, we have not heard of any deaths due to COVID-19. It may be that with our traditional flu treatment's effectiveness, it has helped the Khmer Krom from getting COVID-19. This traditional flu treatment has been said to help so many Khmer Krom abroad to recover who were infected by the COVID-19. Mr. Srivut mentioned in a statement that on July 25th, he wrote a letter to the Sadlin Furniture Company because this company had used the discrimination policy in the layoff and hiring process against the Khmer Krom workers. During the pandemic, the Khmer Krom workers were laid off. After being laid off, they were not able to receive unemployment benefits. With the employment discrimination policy implemented against the Khmer Krom, this would push them to face grinding poverty. It is time for the companies who are doing business with Vietnam to ask that they comply with the ILO's, International Labor Organization, conventions that Vietnam had signed to be a member of since 1992. Mr. Srivut also mentioned that the Khmer Krom youths are facing punishment because of sharing information on social media. As a one-party communist state, Vietnam does not allow a free press. Thus, the only platform that the youths can express their views are through social media. In a previous video, I talked about the Vietnamese government passing decree number 15/2020/ND-CP. It came in effect as of April 15, 2020, to fine social media users who share information that the government considers, in quote, false information and confusing social networks. The two Khmer Krom youths, Tô Hoàng Trường and Thạch Cường, were the victims of this injustice decree. The most crucial issue that Mr. Srivut mentioned in the statement was the case of the confiscated farmland of our Khmer Krom farmers at Phu Mai Village, Giang Than District, Kien Giang Province. I have covered this in a video, so I will not go into details, although I recently received sad news regarding this case. At 8:30 a.m., December 3, 2020, the Vietnamese authority brought Mr. Nguyen Diep, Mr. Thien Dam, also known as Dom, Mr. Thien Nam, and Mrs. Thi Bích to face the mockery trial for the alleged crime of, in quote, resisting a law enforcement officer in performance of his or her official duties, as stated in Article 330 of the Penal Code. According to Article 330.1 of the Penal Code in 2015 and then amended in 2017, in quote, any person who uses violence or threat of violence or other methods to obstruct a law enforcement officer from performing his or her official duties or forces a law enforcement officer to act against the law shall face a penalty of up to 3 years community sentence or 6 to 36 months imprisonment. These Khmer Krom victims, in fact, had a lawyer, and I had mentioned in my previous video that I wanted to see if the lawyer could help the Khmer Krom victims in a regime denying our indigenous rights. It is evident and unfortunate that the lawyer could not defend their clients under the communist rule. The Vietnamese court sentenced Mr. Nguyen Diep for 2 years and 6 months, Mr. Thien Dam for 2 years and 3 months, Mr. Thien Nam for 1 year, and Mrs. Thi Bích for 1 year, suspended sentence, meaning she would not be in prison, but will be on house arrest. The Vietnamese authority sentenced these Khmer Krom victims because of, in quote, resisting a law enforcement officer in performance of his or her official duties. Still, the Vietnamese government did not sentence the officers who used electric batons and tear gas to brutally beat the Khmer Krom farmers who defended their land rights on their ancestral land. The mockery trial of Mr. Nguyen Diep is no different from Mr. Nguyen Ba 10 years ago in 2010. The land rights abuses against the Khmer Krom have continued to happen in Kampuchea Krom. I will conclude this video using the following written statement that one of our Khmer Krom youth, Charlie Tatch, wrote for our Khmer Krom Youth magazine regarding the mockery trial of Mr. Nguyen Ba, and sadly is now still also applicable for the case of Mr. Nguyen Diep. End quote. The outcome of Mr. Nguyen Ba's case is one of the many prime examples of Vietnamese governmental hypocrisies and oppression today. At the United Nations, Vietnam proudly tells the world that according to its constitution, the citizen shall enjoy freedom of opinion and speech, freedom of the press, the right to be informed, and the right to assemble, form associations, and hold demonstrations in accordance with the provisions of the law. And yet, when Mr. Nguyen exercises this right and acts peacefully to hold demonstrations for the return of his ancestral lands, he is charged for abusing democratic freedoms. Ironically, in a country that is controlled by one single party, Vietnamese Communist Party, the Vietnam Penal Codes and Vietnam's constitution are just more tools that are implemented to legitimize their crimes against humanity. Viewers, please join me to help speak up for justice for our Khmer Krom land rights victims in Campuchia Krom. So, Auckland, Chom Riep Lia. Thank you.